सेनेट का एक परिचय गुरुजी ने दिया, जब इसका नाम ये रखा गया साउथ एशियन डायलॉग ऑन इकोलॉजिकल डेमोक्रेसी, तो हम लोगों को इकोलॉजिकल डेमोक्रेसी का एक मोटी मोटी अवधारणा दिमाग में थी, मगर पूरा जो अभी 16 साल का इसकी यात्रा रही है उसमें इस विचार के विभिन्न आयामों को समझना और आयाम को इसमें जोड़ना और उन आयामों को और गहराई से समझने की कोशिश ही इस यात्रा का स्वरूप रहा है। और वो उसकी खोज की यात्रा भी संवाद के द्वारा ही की गई है, तो इसी तरह के संवाद और लोग जो हमारे को इसमें मदद करते रहे हैं उसमें पाठक जी का एक महत्वपूर्ण स्थान रहा है। इकोलॉजिकल डेमोक्रेसी के साथ आज नॉलेज डेमोक्रेसी की बात करना है तो वो क्यों, उसका एक जो मेरी समझ छोटे में कहूँगी, अगर इसमें देखें तो इकोलॉजिकल डेमोक्रेसी में डेमोक्रेसी की बात जब हम समग्र डेमोक्रेसी की बात कर रहे हैं तो डेमोक्रेसी को समझ कैसे रहे। एक पॉलिटिकल डेमोक्रेसी है कि वोट, और हमने उसको पिछले दिनों में उसका काफी व्यापक रूप में देखा भी है, मगर उसके अलावा किसी भी आयाम में डेमोक्रेसी देखें, चाहे वो सामाजिक हो, आर्थिक हो, सांस्कृतिक हो, तो उसमें मेरी समझ से तीन चीजें मूल हैं। अब मैं अंग्रेजी और हिंदी मिक्स करती हूँ ताकि, क्योंकि मार्को हमारे साथ हैं उनको हिंदी में दिक्कत भी होगी। डेमोक्रेसी फिसियस इक्वालिटी म्यूचुअलिटी एंड केयरिंग, अ रिलेशनशिप ऑफ दीज बिटवीन डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस। सो इफ यू आर सेइंग इकोलॉजिकल डेमोक्रेसी, इट इज अबाउट द रिलेशनशिप ऑफ ह्यूमन सोसाइटी एंड नेचर विच इज बेस्ड ऑन दिस रिलेशनशिप ऑफ इक्वालिटी म्यूचुअलिटी एंड केयरिंग एंड इन डेवलपिंग दैट व्हाट आर द वेरियस डायमेंशंस। दिस कैन नॉट हैपन इफ देयर इज कॉन्फ्लिक्ट एंड इनइक्वालिटी and tension within human society itself, and therefore they would have to be the three dimensions seen within the various dimensions of comprehensive democracy that we talked about. We have also moved to seeing this in the Hindi term Harit Swaraj, and ecological democracy as Harit Swaraj is to us a deeper meaning, because democracy, while it is about relationship with others, Swaraj has an added dimension of relationship with oneself. It is about self-rule, not only with the different dimensions outside, and therefore equality between human beings and between human beings and nature. The notion of that developing by control of oneself, one's own life, and of one's own surroundings, as one would like to see it, through the control of oneself from within, and then a social organization that allows for this kind of a control over one's own surroundings, both physical, social, institutional, and so on. To build a social institutional structure of that sort comes from what is the understanding of society and its relationships, and that's what knowledge is about. So knowledge generation, which builds our understanding and also the way we build our understandings in society, is what knowledge democracy would be about. Since in societies like ours, since the colonial onslaught of the last 300 years or so, we have experienced dominance of what developed in the 18th and 19th centuries as modern science and technology. And that has become the dominant form of our understanding of what is valid or legitimate knowledge. And almost all other forms of knowledge have been sidelined to be called either old knowledge, which maybe have been valid earlier but not for the present times, or something which was only superstition and based on belief and had no validity at all. It is in this context where it's a complete reversal of the idea of democracy, where it is a completely undemocratic system across the various knowledge forms and their relationship with each other. And therefore, if we have to build ecological democracy, knowledge democracy will be an inherent dimension of that. There is part realization of this with the wider even international acknowledgement of things like sustainable development goals, which is sort of a culmination at an international level of the ideas of ecological democracy in a governmental form or an intergovernmental form. But this notion of knowledge democracy is not yet recognized within that frame. The dominant form of sustainable development goals today is also then talking about more and newer technologies which will provide the answers. And newer technologies as artificial intelligence, as green technologies which are based on more and more sophisticated of smart cities which will be based on IT and so on. So that's one kind of understanding of how sustainability can be brought onto the group. And obviously with this understanding of comprehensive and ecological democracy, they are quite at loggerheads with this kind of an understanding. So we believe that even in the present international discourse of sustainable development, the idea of ecological democracy as a part of comprehensive democracy is essential. And in that, how do we build understandings that can lead in that direction becomes extremely critical. This also means that we have to look at various diverse streams of understanding and traditions of knowledge, and knowledge not only about technologies and the material world, but knowledge in all its wider sense of all dimensions of human life that we can think of, from the most material to the spiritual and all the various layers in between. So it is to deepen our understanding on that we have requested Pathakji, who is a scholar of Pali and Sanskrit and a practitioner of various traditional knowledge forms, from water systems to health traditions and many others. But these are two that I have witnessed and been familiar with. To help us understand in two streams which are have been historically very prevalent forms in India, Sanatan Dharma and forms of Buddhism. And what do they teach us about knowledge democracy?
Now you want to translate.